So, this is where we left off last time. We are looking good. We are getting rich. That is the most important thing. 22,000 gold per turn. Now we can start growing. Now we can start spamming these armies and move forward. Move somewhere we are scared to move, because at the moment we don't want to fight the Pope, and these guys are not a problem, so I'm not gonna touch them. And it's only one province, which brings a solid amount of Florence, but I don't need it, and I don't wanna upset the Pope, because that's the place the most rebellions happen, so nope. And we have some enemies we can attack. We can go for the strongest one and the most lucrative one. Those are the Egyptians, but they do have the ships. So if I go for them, I have to move all of my armies at once, and then from there conquer everything. We can go for the Golden Horde, and they have few provinces, but the most importantly, they don't have ships. As I see, no ships. Only the yellow and white ones. So maybe the Golden Horde is the best possible fight. Since I don't have ships here, I don't know how strong these guys are. Let's see their alliances. Yeah, they are in alliance with everybody, and even the Egyptians. So I reckon the Byzantines are somewhere on these islands. And Egyptians are here. I don't think the Golden Horde Mongols managed to take this part of Egypt. That's really deep in their territory. But yeah, I'm gonna think about it a bit, not too much, few turns until I get more troops. And then definitely I will go for some of them. I'm expecting the Egyptians to make the first move in the few years I'm gonna take to build my armies up. And if they make that move, that's fine by me. They are opening up their cards and showing me that they wanna fight. So that would be the ideal situation for me. If they attacked first, then I would know where they are focusing their armies. I could stop them there and then push from there. We shall see. I reckon it's better to make the first move, just because you can use your ships. But after that first move, everything else is just how many troops you have. So at the moment, I'm just working on troops. And then we are gonna move in for the kill. Since I am bordered on a lot of sides with them, I have to build troops everywhere. That will secure that they don't move in my area and leave me with enough troops on all sides, so I can use the ships to jump and help out if they attack. They do have a lot of ships, but that's dwarfed when you compare to my fleet. And I can still increase the fleet if I want to, so that's the fight they won't win. So yeah, make the first move. And just spamming these armies. Nothing special here, boring. And yeah, I'm hoping that rebellions are gonna stop, or at least I don't wanna see 13 or 20 rebellions like we had in the last part. It would be nice to have a few turns without any rebellions. I'm hoping that the troops will help out, a huge amount of troops that I'm building at the moment. Is it okay to say building troops? I don't know. Recruiting. I guess recruiting is the best word for it. Okay, we're building everywhere. Recruiting. Okay, let's end this turn and see what's our gold situation after it. And the Golden Horde attacked me. Interesting. Really interesting. Did they attack me? Yes, they did. Fine. Fine by me. Really fine by me. Now we can use these troops to push against them. And we're gonna push hard. Here and then go forward and kill. Oh, nearly attacked the wrong enemies. So let's see. These troops I won't touch. These neither. I need them to defend. This is a high risk area where the rebellions are happening at the moment. This is totally now this area. I'm gonna place the defensive troops inside, and the leftovers will be focused on fighting the Mongols. And every new troop that I make will be outside, so I will know that they are the ones that I can use, for example, like these. I'm not gonna touch this part. Leave it. Oh, look at the chaos up top. So many troops. And I'm gonna use them to conquer Scotland and keep it for this time. Okay, let's use these mercenaries. They will come in. I want to kill them. Yeah, let's move as much as we can. You're going inside. And you are going to the battlefront. You too. I'm not gonna touch anything here. Rebellions are occurring still here. Fine. I think that sums it up. Let's end the turn and see what happens. Easy. Easy. Okay, and the Egyptians are doing their move. Fine. Okay. Three ships lost to the enemy. No, 4-2. 4-3. 5-3. 5-4. 6-4. Nice. 8-4. 8-5, and a good amount of gold. So all in all, we did crush their fleet. Okay, good. Do we want to be friends with the Pope? Of course we do. Even though we are gonna kill him in the end. Okay, let's build troops here. This is a position I want to keep, and let's build a shipyard. Now from here, We have to split up our armies since we are fighting two enemies at once. And we have to keep the pressure on. See the situation with the ships. This is good, good, good. Let's move one ship from here and replenish the ships we lost. And they do not have the control of these parts, which is good. Okay, boat battle is gonna happen here. I won't move these ships. We will go here. Yeah, we are establishing control again. Okay, we lost ships here, so we are gonna build them. But from where? Where can we build ships? Ah, perfect. Perfecto. We can hire some mercenaries since we are swimming in gold. We're gonna do that. Now, let's build more troops, recruit more troops here in Hungary. And that is about to sum it up. Let's build ships. Where we first we need to find a port that can build ships. Yeesh. They should have split up the troops from ships so I can scroll faster. Like this, I have to search. Ships, ships. Need more ships. This should do it. Now. Yeah, this is okay. Let's see what's gonna happen. They are losing. And I forgot to defend my castle there. A rookie mistake. But we have Constantinople. And we wanna ship fight. Nope. You have conquered more than 60% of Europe. You may claim your victory or continue onwards to total European domination. Do you wish to claim the lesser victory? Fuck no! We are gonna go full mode on this walkthrough. They're starting a jihad. I'm gonna crush it. I forgot to take out Scotland, the keep, and conquer it fully. Now, these troops are going here. Where are the mercs? Here they are. I want the mercs to be fighting and dying, because they are expensive. Let's take this cast out and deal with my mistakes. Well, those things happen. And now, what can I do from here? I can probably start moving these troops. And just create diversions. Destroy their armies. Let's push them back. Now let's do this. Aggressive. This is going to be a huge battle, and we can do this. Oh, I totally forgot they own this area. Sardinia, if I remember, it's the name of the area. Definitely. Ah, yeah, ships, ships, ships. Well, I can go from here. This is the only way. I can't check their troops out. Maybe from here? No. From here? Nope. We don't have a port. Nope. Nope. Definitely stuck. I'm gonna wait a bit. Let's make an inn. Maybe we can build mercenaries in 2 years and speed up the process. But you can see, when I sorted out the armies and placed them in the castle, the new troops were spawning in front of the castle, and that way I know I have enough troops in the castle to defend this province. And everything that's outside is ready to be moved and ready for battle. So that's a neat trick. It simplifies everything. Yeah, they are losing control. Oh, look at that. Oh, perfect. Ooh. Ooh. They are fighting back. But yeah. Some you win, some you lose. Okay, we're losing ships. 3 ships sunk. Starting to get interesting. Okay, you're gonna move back and take back our lands. Now you're gonna conquer this base. And you're gonna conquer this. Oh, mercenaries, perfect. I'm gonna buy all of them. Yep. Now. Oh yeah. Forgot all about the Italians, and this is a problem, but I can leave these two areas and Italians will do the dirty work for me, and I can come back because they don't have any ships at the moment. So I'm just gonna destroy their armies on the mainland, and they will be stuck there, really not present a big threat to me at the moment. If they get the ships, it's gonna be a sticky situation. But I won't let them. We are still waiting on the first batch of the ships. I reckon next year it's gonna happen. Yeah, we are cut off. These troops are stagnating here. Let's move them. And we should assault this castle. Everything is looking good. Let's see if we can build some emissaries. Nope. Here, maybe? Yeah, this is the perfect area to do it since we have troops. Emissaries will come in handy with these neutral areas. And I'm not paying attention at the moment on our gold, since we are gonna lose a lot of troops in these fights, and we are gonna pillage a lot of Florence. It's kinda a shoot in the dark, a shot in the dark to look at the gold. You never know. As you see, it's jumping up. Even if I'm losing, it's gonna go up. Jeez. Good. I did what I wanted to do. Cut them off on the mainland. Finally. And we lost one ship. And some gold we raised. I didn't see the Polish people in a long time. They could appear at any second. Fine, let's move. Troops are getting here. Okay, let's send out the mercs to do the job, and then we'll split up these armies. This should be enough. Assault of the castle. Okay, we took a huge blow there, but now they're coming back stronger. Okay, our first batch of ships is done. Now we can start moving. See how much damage did they do to us. Okay, we need to deal with this. Hopefully this will be enough. Let's send out some troops there. That we just sent. Okay, that's enough. And the mercs lost. That's bad. But we won. And that was a free battle, a free win. So we get to keep a lot of our troops. Those battles are the best when they just surrender and surrender the keep and just leave the province. You want to have as much as you can get of those battles. Good. Ow, ouch, ouch. Yeah, you can have it. I don't care. Let's see our gold status. It's fine, 5,000 gold per turn. It's still fine. Okay, we have more ships here. Let's leave one. Attack. And this one. Click on it and then check out 3-3 speed. Yeah, definitely this one has better attack, and since we are fighting I'm gonna use these. Oh, he can double leap. Epic. I forgot about that. Let's see, where did we mess up? Yeah, we messed up here on this rebellion. Let's hire some mercs. Even more. They're gonna help out. Let's see if we have any more mercs anywhere. Seems we don't. What will I do next? More troops. Oh, we can build ships here. Or troops. Let's build troops for now. Yeah, that's the better thing to do, since I am starting to lose a lot of them. Let's get some power here, and I cannot use the ships, so that's the logical thing to do. Okay, this should be fine. Let's see what awaits us. Good. Okay. Finally. They're teaming up against me. And we won a battle on the sea. I'm fine with these rebellions that are happening right now. That's because I conquered them and they're refusing to be under my command, because I am a Catholic faction and they are Muslims and they have been under Egyptian rule for a long time, and they're just refusing, which is fine. But we have to move troops. I cannot wait any more longer for the boats. I do want it. do that, but it's not feasible at the moment. If I keep standing in one place, they will overwhelm me with these rebellions. So it's time to make some moves. I'm gonna move as much as I can. And since I have the boats here, and the Italians are neutral, so I'm not gonna fight them. There's absolutely no need for that. I'm gonna keep these troops in case I w win this ship battle. And I can definitely do this. Let's wait it out. Let's wait it out. Let's move the troops to the sea, to the shore. And then when we have, yeah, that's the best thing to do. The fastest. Because I'm gonna win it. I'm gonna win the ongoing sea battle. And when that happens, I have a huge amount of troops to move and to attack with them. Yeah, let's wait it out. I'm changing my mind a lot, but the amount of work required to move the troops over the land, I don't want to do that. Okay, and I did forget it. Mistakes were made. And the Pope is attacking me. Why? Without any allies and fighting two religions, they won't give me a break. No, they won't. Now, the question for me, why did Pope attack me? That is the real question. Let's keep moving these troops to the shorelines. To defend this area. Let's build more troops here. Some mercs again. Oh, we can. Anywhere else? Here too. We're gonna use that. Why not? And this was the place. Yeah, this was the place. Now I'm conserving my troops because the rebellions are happening and I don't wanna push yet. I want more troops and I want those ships. So we have the second batch of ships and we can make a move again. Okay, you two are going here. I think this will do it. We have a huge amount of ships on our disposal. They totally destroyed us here, but we are getting ships here too, so we can help out on this side. deal with this, but we can't. Can we? Should be able to deal with them. Those are the high quality troops. Okay, let's see what happens. Good. Good. Better. Good. And the high quality troops have failed me. Okay. I'm gonna leave this area out. I don't want to get the notification for rebellions anymore. You can have it. There's nothing there for me. So take it. Now. We are building, recruiting. Chance, and now 34, 0, and then 37, 7, 44, 34. Yeah, I have to do a lot of micromanaging here. Troops from one side, there's a chance of a rebellion on the other. Let's see, where can we jump? Still not enough. Yeah, we are not connected here. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Mercenaries are helping a lot. We managed to get the entire army from them. Now let's see what's gonna happen after this turn. The ship up there, but fortunately we can use these ships to push them back, since we have a lot of ships here. Yep, and hopefully they won't get defeated in the second round. And now everything is connected. Except this part here. Now let's see. More troops. some free troops here, which we are gonna use. What's the it's good, it's 0%. So that won't happen there. And we can do this. Take back our lands. Assault this castle. And let's see what happens. And we are losing gold. Which is okay, I'm really not bothered at the moment. Our armies are growing. So Hungarians have appeared again, and I have to deal with that. And we are fighting four factions at the moment. How fun. How fun. Let's crush these guys here and then split up the armies. No more mercs. I can defend against this much of enemies. Not yet still. I can defend some areas. But no, I don't think I can defend all of them. I can send these troops here. And here, and hope and pray for the best. So the ship situation, did I move my ships in this turn? No, I didn't. Okay, let's keep moving. And hopefully they will lose the ship here, so I can establish control, and this one here. Good. Now I'm gonna retreat to my stronghold. I can't win this battle. Too much troops. No, and I cannot win this one too. But I can stop them a little bit. Assault. Good. I'm gonna abandon it. They can have it. And I can win this one, definitely. And the storm is not helping. Oh well. Now there's a huge Hungarian army, which is gonna be dealt with swiftly in this turn. Okay, let's see what's the boat situation now. We still can't jump yet because of this boat here. Let's attack it. Let's move this boat. Let's attack. Yeah, we have to attack, nothing else. We need to be able to jump. Yeah, you can take it. Oh no. Good. They are pushing again. And the Pope is annoying me again. Okay, we won one. We won one. I don't give a F about you, Pope. You're attacking me. Yeah, you are. Be happy that I'm not focusing you at the moment. So I should end it right now. Good, good, bad. Okay, good, 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 and that's over with Hungarians. And that's it for the rebellions, at least for this turn. I should be destroying my enemies with my ships, but that's not happening. It's not going to plan. But I'm getting a new batch of ships, so I'm gonna keep on coming. let's split up these armies. This is gonna come in handy. Terrible situation, still good. We have a huge army here, which we can use. And I'm definitely gonna use them for this. Let's strike a big blow. Yep, we can. Cannot use the boats yet. Finally. And I'm gonna move the troops here, so they are close to the shoreline. And I'm gonna leave some so they can defend. Up here, if I remember, yep. The rebellion occurred. We're gonna build boats here. This should be enough. So I'm gonna build boats here and here, since I can. And then I'm going to avoid having to move all of my ships. Okay, we have a ship that's doing absolutely nothing here, but we can't move him, so I'm gonna just leave him there. This is gonna be enough for this turn. No need to be mega aggressive. Okay, Italians took the chance. Chance to help out their allies, and they routed out a ton of my 5,000 Florians and plus. Yeah, I'm gonna take care of that nuisance. Right now, they can help them out, I don't care. I'm gonna send a huge amount of troops there to deal with the Italians and the Egyptians on these two islands, because I can. Let's use those ships. Tidy up enemies. Yeah, tidy up units. I didn't select that, and I should have. That's why I'm having so much armies. I'm I'm not gonna move anything from here, this is enough. Maybe just a little bit more. This should help up, help out there. And these guys should go there too. So I can use them later on. Okay, looking good. Actually, I can move all of these troops since I can't move other ones and the king. If I move, what's the rebellion chance? Zero. Cool. Muster up here at the moment. Oh yeah. I hope this doesn't bite me in the ass. Looking nice. Ships, 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 ships for days. And as you noticed, these ships can travel in the deep sea and these can't, so you have to know that, because if you don't connect the deep sea with the shorelines, you are losing a lot of mobility. And we should, yeah, ships are gonna be ready soon there. Okay, let's tidy up these units and see what exactly they're working with. Okay, two decent armies. Let's leave some. Okay. What's the goal situation? 5,000. Fine. Thousand troops on that little island. Okay, okay, I don't care. But we had a huge army somewhere up here that rebelled. Here. Let's deal with that. And let's do this. This was the whole idea behind the huge troop moving. Okay, let's deal with the Italians. Ah! blah blah, Pope. They're gonna die. And you're gonna love it. Okay. Send out a bit of troops here. That was expected. Portugal is quite hard to defend and requires a lot of troops. Then we have our boats, which we are gonna use right away. And we have our boats here. And this opens up the map. So how are we gonna do this? Like this. Fine, let's end the turn and let's see what's the situation. 2000. Pushing deep into the Golden Horde provinces. Of course, I have plenty men, and the map is getting quite wide, which I don't have a problem with. Let's move our boats once again. No, let's use the big ones. Good. Yeah, deep sea. Anything here? Nope. Yeah, we're waiting on this boat to get completed. Assaulted this castle so we can build here. Let's do this and this. And assault this castle. And assault this castle. Leave some troops. No, let's not leave. Let's do this. And then let's deal with this nuisance here. Cannot do that, but we can. Yes. And the troops are looking good. Let's just split up a bit our armies to avoid any more rebellions. And we can move from here to. Can we? Yes, we can. This is gonna be good. Let's assault this castle. Let's move you. We can't. Let's move here and then we can move with the boats since we have the boatyard. Yeah, I'm gonna start pushing from this side because we do have a lot of troops. which we are going to send to the shorelines. Okay, so far so good. We are getting closer to the end. Winning a battle after the battle. And that's it with the Italians. Good. I'm not gonna pray. I'm gonna fight the death, the plague. Let's make more troops. Leave some so we can finish the work. Now, eventually, I will get stopped. Troops here are stuck, so I have to build a boatyard, shipyard. Okay, looking fine. Gold income. We are losing some gold. We're gonna see in the next turn. Where are our troops? You can use the gold income, and look at this. We have made a new enemy. But I defended you for so long. Why you do me like that? Why? Now I have to crush you. That was a dick move. Fine by me. I like to be passive and then aggressive. Kinda best tactic for this game. Just waiting for them to mess up. And few turns back, I did create a lot of emissaries, which I'm going to use too. Can't go there. Can't bribe them. I'm gonna do this. Nope. Nope. For now, let's just move them to the shoreline so they can use the boats. And then we shall see. Okay, everything is looking fine. We're gonna move our troops from here. It's time to push from all sides. And this is a decent army. Here with the pushing, just want to conquer all of these castles. I'm gonna send help here. And we have a new boat, which is perfect. Now we can use these to expand, to actually be able to jump everywhere we want to. Anywhere else? Nope, that's it. Oh, huge amount of ships here. Everything is getting connected and working out fine. It's so much easier to play without those rebellions happening. So, a little bit less than 4,000 troops. The Byzantines, and we found a use for our emissaries. We're gonna take this island. Okay, let's deal with this. This should be enough. There's no point in making friends at the moment. Only point is battle. Till I run out of gold or units. I'm just going to push them back as much as I can. Good, the good troops. And once more. Fine by me. I should build more boats here. Just to be safe. Okay, let's end the turn. Forgot to take out the Aragonese. I'm just gonna split up the armies again because I don't wanna leave my province is susceptible to rebellions. The Egyptians want to be friends, but I don't. I really don't. Ah, I forgot about that. Sorry. And that's it for one enemy. Two enemies in one turn. And Pope wants to be friends. Oh yeah? Let's be friends and then I'm gonna kill you. I'm getting closer to total domination. Use these troops. everything is getting real nice, real nice. Everything is connected. Just this part here. Now connected. This part here and this part, and that's it. So two more boats. In the next turn I should be able to use all of these troops and transfer them on the main focused area where we are fighting. And I forgot again to use the income to find where the majority of my troops are. I'm definitely going to stop at Egypt, since my troops are getting lower in numbers. Let's do this. Maybe I can push to one more province. Good. Let's use the king and conquer this. And let's use these and go here. This is okay for now. Because when I get there, rebellions will happen and I need to defend it. Okay, let's find our troops. Yeah, I just have a lot of provinces. And that's it. Okay, Venice. Venice needs troops. As soon as possible. Who else needs troops? Avoid rebellions at the end, if it's possible. Nobody else. Oh, zero. We're looking for a zero. And rum. They're gonna get troops soon. Yeah, this is okay. Let's see what's gonna happen. Okay, it wasn't enough. That's fine. It's fortunate enough that we have ships there. Yep. We can do this. Okay, we can keep expanding. So only one more ship, or no, I think we might have enough. I'm just checking which ships can go where I want them to go. These are the middle sea ones. Yep, I think we are connected. Nope, we aren't. But we are going to be. Jeez. Yeah. I moved them from here. And now, yeah, it seems everything is connected. Yeah. So in the next turn, everything is possible. Everything. Let's keep building troops here. Mercenaries, why not? Why not? We are rich. And I have to deal with this again. I'm trying to build, recruit troops near the sea, because that is simplifying the whole process, because I can, as soon as they are completed, I can use them with my boats at the moment. And let's build a fort here. And these troops are, in my opinion, one of the best Muslim faction troops. They get in and get the job done. Status, we have three enemies. Four. One, two, three, four, five. Five fractions to deal with. We are getting closer. Now, yeah, they are stuck, and our king is not stuck, but we need to build a port here so we can actually move these troops. Now, time to do some micromanaging. And move every single troop we can move to fight down here. No, you can't, because there is no port there. Definitely. There are more troops. I'm probably going to make a huge army, and this will be possible. This will work. Let's zoom out a bit so I don't have to scroll that much. Okay, this will work too. You know what? I'm gonna do a quick army building recruitment on the shores. Yeah, because I can use them immediately. I don't wanna wait too long for, I don't know, enemies can appear and crush me. want to finish it. Since we are this close, there aren't much provinces to conquer. I want to finish it before it gets sticky, before like 10 rebellions happen, a fraction rebellions, before French and English and everybody appear. I should be able to do it. Can't believe I'm this close to ending it on expert. Never crossed my mind to play it on expert, but it's looking good. It's looking fine. No more need for boats. Army power. Yeah. That's the only thing that interests me at the moment. These are the weak ones. Yep. Yep. And yep. Now I see in Scandinavian countries we have spare units, which we will definitely use. Not much, but it's gonna help out. Just use these leftovers. I'm not gonna touch Scotland because as soon as I move 50% of the creeps, it will get annoying again. Okay, let's see what's gonna happen. Okay, this guy is defending good. 4,000, nice. And we can use our king right now. And the thing that is retarded to me is this island. They're getting 600 gold per year, and look how much units they have. How many florins are they in debt at the moment? I'm really curious about that. Okay, the Pope is next, and the Sicilians. I know. One more enemy down. Let's go for the golden horde, and yeah, this will do it. This will be enough to take him out. Let's just send extra troops. The map is looking damn fine. Okay, I'm gonna split up again the troops. This should be enough. I cannot go for the Sicily from here. I have to transfer them there. And from there I can move on to Sicily and Malta. Because they do have ships here. But if I kill those ships, I can do it. Maybe that's the better opportunity and situation. I have to deal with them and the Pope. I'm just thinking, what should I do? I have to be quick and swift about it. The Pope does not have much, a huge army, which is good. I can do this. Yeah, it's gonna be easy. This is gonna be a piece of cake. Okay, Pope is under attack. And after that, yeah, let's go for Sicilians. Let's wage wars. We are close to the end. Let's move these troops. Take them out. And now the only thing that can stop me at the moment are the rebellions. They will crush me if I mess this up. Now, can I find enough troops? That's the question. Can I find enough troops to go for them? These troops won't work. I don't have a port there. These will work. Let's try it out. Let's try to get everything in one turn. Who knows, maybe it will work. This won't work since we don't have a port there. Them all. We are going in. We are getting greedy. We are getting real greedy. And this proves how important the boats are in this game. I don't think it's even possible to beat the game without the boats. Maybe on easy. But it takes a lot of time. And with boats you can just do this, crush your enemies, no stress. Now I am getting ready to go and battle them, and I should be able to get the Sicilians in the next turn. This was enough. Epic. Everything is going as... I didn't say anything. And we lost a battle there. No, I don't want to be communicated. You're gonna regret that. Right now. The map is looking good. It's looking real good. And only one enemy remains. And I have to deal with this, with his ships. Can we bribe him? Where are my emissaries? Let's try to bribe him. We are getting closer. Good. Finally managed to. No. I don't want rebellions. We are getting close. 3,000 florins. or straight on battle. I can probably do it. Yeah, let's do it. Let's go ape shit on them. So what do we have here? Will this be enough? Let's risk it. Hopefully this should end it. Let's see, did we manage to beat the game on expert, or will we get a huge rebellion all over the map? Okay, this will be enough, and this should be enough. Okay. Ooh, that was close. Yep, there goes the Golden Horde. And yep, this was enough too. And this was enough too. And we did it, boys. Yep. Medieval Total War beaten on expert level. Took me until 1358 to beat it, and it was a rocky start, hard start. We were struggling for, I don't know, 100-150 years, but after that we just owned it. And in the biggest progress I made, it was in last 50 years of the gameplay. It just exploded when I managed to establish the boat control over the seas, and after that it was easy, as you saw. Thank you for watching. It was a good experience doing this game. I don't know how much will you enjoy watching me play it, because it's a turn-based game and it's fun to play, but I don't know how fun it is to watch. And I know I was mumbling and rumbling from time to time, but that's because I was focusing on the gameplay. I'm sorry because of that. And hopefully you enjoyed it, and I'm gonna do Viking Invasion next, and I'm gonna upload it. And yeah, thank you, and see you next time.